What's going on YouTube? So I already did a video talking about replacing a originally AGM type battery with a lead standard one. I did say in that video that if your car has start stop feature and you don't disable it, keep by all means AGM battery. But for any other, you may want to try replacing an AGM with a standard acid lead battery. Just wanted to add one more thing. You see, this is a Hyundai, but other cars do have the same thing. And by the way, this is just a wire for a solar charger, nothing to do with the video. One of the things you may want to try if you go, if you choose to replace with acid lead, you see, this is the negative post, this is positive. So the negative one, you may find some kind of a wire with perhaps a sensor to it. This plug here, this is called ACM battery temperature sensor. So it's an extra sensor that would read perhaps the battery temperature. I don't know how it's doing it, but and I think this is meant specifically for AGM batteries, and this is on top of the alternator regulator. It's just sending extra information for the computer to regulate the alternator charging of the battery. In my opinion, and please look in the comment section, sometimes I will update my videos with the comment section because I cannot change the video itself once uploaded. But look in the comment section, the top of the comment section, if I would put an update. But in my opinion, you don't need this sensor for acid lead battery because it's meant, from what I understand, for AGM batteries which charge a little bit different than acid lead ones. So what I do recommend, if you go with acid lead instead of AGM, I don't recommend you disconnect the sensor, just unplug the fuse for the sensor. Leave the sensor attached so you don't mess with it, so it doesn't corrode the leads and stuff, and just remove the fuse. Check in the fuse panel, usually mine was inside the car, has a separate fuse. I did unplug the fuse. The moment I did unplug the fuse, I did notice that the voltage, because I read the voltage in real time, and I link another video in comment section how to do that. I did notice that the voltage was more, it was slightly lower than when this sensor is plugged in. So perhaps it's charging more than like for an acid lead battery. Perhaps it's safer for acid lead to unplug the fuse for this sensor. Again, go in the comment section when you watch this video, see if there is any update. Let us know your own experience. Just a tip, I'm not 100% sure it's a good idea to remove the fuse for the sensor, but for now I'm going to do it, and I'm going to keep driving like this.